job to figure things out. If you have a real question, you'll be man or woman enough to ask. And you can ask me to my face. And if you don't have the guts to ask me to my face, you better not talk about me behind my back, because you might drop dead. Because the word of the Lord said, touch not mine anointed, and do my prophets no harm. And before you let the devil lie to you and tell you I'm just turning on for you, I told them in Dallas, I dare you to talk about me. I dare you. And one man laughed, but the same flesh-eating disease that one woman got healed of, he stormed out of my service in the offering and started talking about me, and the hole began to form on the back of his neck before he got home. And they took him to the hospital, and they said, we can't help you.
Tell him.
So I dare you to talk about me.
That's right.
Bring up 20 years ago.
That's right.
And just say it loud. Make sure you dot your I's and cross your T's. Because when you talk about me, you take your life in your own hands. And I'm telling you that I don't just talk like this in Saskatchewan. I talk like this everywhere I go. And one thing the German is not is a liar. And he'll tell you, this is me. Because something has happened in me. And God's given me a new boldness. And I have to go. I don't care who walks out. I don't care who tries to get up and to interfere with my service, because they get booted out fast. I don't care who says whatever they want, they can say it. They said in Dallas, something happened to you, prophet. You used to cry a lot. You don't cry no more unless it's the Holy Ghost. They said, my God, we thought you were rough 7 years ago. You're not the same.
Amen.
And I don't know when it happened. And I don't know how. I don't know where it happened, but there came a, I don't care for you. I don't care what demon walks in this place.
Yeah.
I'm not afraid. I'm not playing games. Jesus is coming soon. And I'm not doing part of what he said. I'm doing it all. Religion. I'm sick and tired of people that say they're saved and they don't belong and they have no power. They say they have the Holy Ghost. You don't have the Holy Ghost. You have one of those familiar spirits that can turn on in the club when you're shaking it low, and can turn on in the church when you're trying to dance and roll. And God said, it's time to get back to your first love.
Amen.
And he said, I don't want your leftover garbage. He said, I want your best. I don't want a sacrifice that doesn't cost you anything. I want your best. God said, you're living in houses. I need you. You're driving vehicles. I need you. You're media. You're working on jobs. I need you. You have blessing. I need you. It's not yours.
Just in case you might have a weak day.
Yeah.
You get rid of all of it.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
And you get into your phone and you delete every number of anybody that you know that has anything to do with it. Because God wants you delivered.
Amen.
And there's some people in this place that have been delivered from drugs. Anybody here not afraid to stand up and say, I used to be an alcoholic, I used to be a drug addict, I used to be bound by cigarettes, and I'm free now? Can you know you're free? Anybody know God did it for you? But the key is, you have to want to be set free.
Amen.
And some days, you will walk out of the meeting so mad that you can spit at me. But if you'll do what I tell you to do, it's going to work.
Amen.
It's going to work.